Let's talk about finding bugs and fixing them. The term bugs is used for mistakes in your code. The term actually comes from the early days of computing, when computers used to be the size of wardrobes or entire rooms, and actual bugs that got into the machine caused it to malfunction. Nowadays, bug fixing is the process of identifying and resolving errors or flaws in your code. It involves carefully examining the code, looking for mistakes that may cause unexpected behavior or crashes. When debugging, it's essential to pay attention to detail. We will take you through some of the most common mistakes that beginners make.
All right, our sample is a little guessing game. I import the random module first, then I generate a random number between 0 and 9, and now I want the user to guess it. You can see here in this for loop, which is executed exactly 3 times, I ask the user to guess a number between 0 and 9, and I take this number, turn it into an integer, and if the user guesses correctly, I will exit this for loop with a break. That means the loop is ended immediately, or else I will say, sorry, your guess was wrong, and the user has to guess again. Now, when I try this program, it gives me an error message. Of course, these error messages are always very useful, and under most circumstances, I would just say look at the error message closely and find out what's going on. But in this case, I will actually find the error by commenting out a few lines here. So I will start with the end and comment out these lines, and then check again. And if the error message is still there, then I know that the error is in the previous part of my programming code. And if not, then I know that it must have been in these lines that I commented out. It is easy for me now to see that the error must be somewhere in this for loop, and I can find it really quickly. You can see I basically just forgot the opening parenthesis. Once I fix this and uncomment the lines at the bottom again, I can run it, and you can see now it runs perfectly. Remember, when fixing bugs, it is often extremely helpful to comment out several lines so that you can identify which of the lines contain the error. Another very useful tool when debugging your code is the print function. You can see this looks correct at first glance, and I can try it out now. And you can see it runs, there's no error message. But if I really want to know what's going on, then I can use the print function to help. Inside the for loop, I can use the print command and show the random number that was generated that the user has to guess. And once I do that and run the program, I will immediately be able to compare the numbers that I enter and the number that was generated. And you can see here, it says, sorry, your guess was wrong, even though the number was 5. So apparently there's some kind of mistake in my code, which I wouldn't have caught so easily if I hadn't shown the number that was generated. It turns out in this case that I forgot to turn the number into an integer before comparing it. Here you see the line in which I compare the number that was entered with the number that was generated, but the number that was entered is treated as a string. Anything that is entered through the input function is a string. Remember that. So what I need to do is I need to typecast it and make this an integer. And here we go. We compare an integer with an integer now. And now this program code should work flawlessly. All right, here's another common mistake. Can you find it? Of course, it's a misspelling. This happens all the time one of the things you should always check is, are your variables spelled correctly? Here's another very common mistake. Can you spot it? As you can see, the error code already gives us a hint. We forgot to indent the block that comes inside the if statement. This is always a very important thing to do. Never forget indentation. In this code, we ask the user to insert a payment offer, and if it's too low, we tell the user so. So what's wrong? This might be difficult to spot, but what you see in the line number 2 that starts with if is not a real number. The supposedly zeros are actually O's. So it is easy to confuse numbers and letters sometimes. Make sure numbers and letters are all correct. Same program, different mistake. Can you spot it? Yeah, it's right here. Payment has a capital P, and that means it's another variable. We need to pay attention to the case, if it's lowercase or uppercase, and variables should be lowercase anyway. All right, let's move on to the next mistake. What's wrong now? Can you spot it? Well, here we have the problem that the parenthesis here is not closed at the end. So there are two opening parentheses and only one closing parenthesis. So one is missing. Always make sure you have as many closing parentheses as opening parentheses. It's the same program, but this time we've introduced two mistakes of the same kind. Can you spot them? So here, the problem is actually the quotation marks. You can see in the first line that I'm starting with double quotes and ending with a single quote. And of course, that is not valid code. I have to end with a double quote if I start with a double quote. And of course, here in the last line, you can see that I forgot to close this with a double quote, so there was nothing there. This should fix it. So the last thing I want to remind you of is that you always save your code after fixing the mistakes. Because if you don't, you will still run the old code and you might get extremely frustrated and not understand what's wrong. And the trick is just that it runs the old code and hasn't really applied your changes yet. So make sure you save before running the new code again.
In summary, when your program isn't running, find out which part of your code isn't working by using the hashtag in front of some lines to keep them from being executed. Also, make use of the print function to show you the value of variables, for instance in a loop. When looking for mistakes, you can also go through this list. Spelling. Is everything spelled correctly? Indentation. Do you have unnecessary spaces at the start of a line? Numbers and letters. Have you confused any numbers for letters, such as 0 and O? Letter case. Have you used uppercase and lowercase letters in the right places? Parentheses. Do all open parentheses have a matching closing parentheses? Quotes. Do all single and double quotes have a matching closing quote? Saving. Have you saved your code since you last made changes? And that's all. We'll leave you with that. Thank you so much for learning Python with us, and have fun coding.